Yeah, that is big. You could probably get 4 or 5 bodies in there.
Today in the woodyard, we're cutting wood. Woo! Already.
Tractor up at the house up there plugged in, so it was semi-warmed up a little bit, and so what I've been doing, I got the wood out by the road, by the driveway, I lay it out here, I cut it, and I put my bucket on, I shoved it over here by the splitter so I don't have to handle it. Right now we got the generator running, we got a heater on the splitter. It's been anywhere from 35 below to 20 below for the last week. We had one warm day. This morning was around 20 again, and now it's, I don't know what it is.
It's about 10, maybe 5 or 10?
It's maybe 5 degrees. So
he's got the generator running, and he's got a heater inside of there.
Yeah, what we got here? It's covered up. We got a little space heater. Oh, yeah, nice and warm. She's gonna start right up. Sit at home in the garage. Chainsaws are already warmed up,
gassed up.
We'll let that run for a while. We got to cut this up just a little bit here. And then once this is cut up, I'll shove it over there.
You switch back to your bucket, right?
Yeah, I just switch the bucket back home once this is cut up. And we'll cut up the stringers too. It's going to be bad. There's some frozen mud on there. We might be sharpening a little. And one saw is sharp, one's not. So we might be sharpening sooner than later. My granddaughter Braylon, and she came along today. Ain't she beautiful? And she is gonna be our
camera girl
today. Yeah, so we'll see how she does.
How are you gonna do it? You're gonna move the camera like this?
No,
you're gonna go slow, right?
Okay, can you see me? Go film Grandpa. I'm sweating. I got too many clothes on for cutting.
I know.
I mean, but being on a tractor.
I want to get working now.
Yeah, I'm soaked.
So you had a tragedy I saw.
When?
You spilt your beer.
Yeah, that cup doesn't like it when you run over them chunks of wood with the...
All right, so now we're going to do some splitting.
Yep.
Here we are. Here I am overdressed. You've seen we just cut a little bit. I had my coveralls on because I knew I was going to be on the track. I was dressed light. I'm good now.
But I'm sweated. So that's how I've been doing it here in the wintertime because the ground is frozen. I can shove this wood around like hockey pucks. It works pretty good. I just lay out a little bit.
Yep.
I don't normally do a bigger pile than this because that's about all I want to push with the tractor.
Right.
You see how I'm bouncing off it and everything
else. It's probably going to be maybe two face cords.
Might be, maybe, whatever. But I usually do two piles like that, and then I do one at a time up here.
Right.
Because it's too much to push.
Right.
And I spin out on this ice. So then, you know, normally I would add another pile over there. We'd split this up, and I'd shove it over there, and I get back on that side, and I keep pushing it to the splitter. And this, I don't know if you can see over here, where I've been dumping it. This is what I've been working on for the last month.
So you're just dumping it in a pile now?
Yeah, my pallets got all pushed over with the snow plow and covered with snow. And I got pallets behind there. But this is what I've been working on for about I'm just going to say a month. I don't know.
Got a lot of railroad ties in there.
Yeah, there was a whole truckload of ties out there at the road. The ones we're doing right now are just the ones that got buried underneath that second load. So these are, I got to think, 3-cord rows? Yeah. So there's 15 cords right there. And I can put another 15, another 15, and another 15. This pile here is 30 cords. That pile over there is over 30 cords. This pile here, Chris filmed this last summer. This is stuff all got cut last summer. Pretty much everything here.
Right.
That pile over there underneath all that crap, there's like 30 cords under that pile.
So this let's get splitting.
Yeah, we're running out of daylight.
Thank you.
dump out the bucket. Gotta grab some chains, and we're gonna get some wood up to the house for Todd.
Yeah, that is big. You could probably get 4 or 5 bodies in there.
Oh, heck yeah. You can get a bunch of people in there.
That is a big boiler.
Yeah, one wheelbarrow load, like, whoa, they have a whole lot. Been cold going here.
Well, what the heck, your light, is that a motion light or what?
Yeah.
Big stuff or little stuff?
Oh, you got all kinds of big stuff, man.
Kenny likes to cut them big.
Well, the nice thing is they last long. The bad thing is you got to lift them.
Like that one.
Yeah. Have Kenny put that one in. I'll hold your beer. You put it in.
I watch the fingers by the doorway. Yeah, that's probably these big ones. You can't throw them very far. You want stuff with more. You want some more maple in there, though. Then
put some of this oak in there.
This is hard maple here.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like putting a toothpick in there.
Yeah, I know it.
I come back at 10 o'clock tonight, do it again.
Jeez. That's a bad thing about these giant boilers, especially when you're heating your workshop and your house.
Yeah.
It's always hungry. It's always hungry. Yeah, it's like throwing a couple toothpicks in there.
There's everyone. Not even full.
No, you need 3 wheelbarrows full. Jeez.
Oops. The whole tree wheelbarrow loads.
Yeah. Yeah, you're about not even half full.
There's a lot of ashes in there, too.
Yeah, I know.
If I clean that much ashes out,
yeah.
Get more in.
Is that enough for tonight, then?
Till 10.
Oh, jeez. So there we go. We did some work today.
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit. Tomorrow we have a full day of doing work. So tomorrow we're going to cut all of this and split all this and then stack all this.
Right.
No, so we just, we got done. We moved the wood into the pile over there. Then we cleaned up your area. And then we dragged some logs over to Todd's.
Yep. I got to pay my rent. That's how I pay my rent. I keep that boiler. You're going to see videos of the boiler. That's my rent.
Yeah, well, they just did. It's on there. We put it on there.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I mean, so that's. So we're going to do that tomorrow. We're going to cut a bunch up for him. We're going to drag a bunch more up by the boiler and put some stuff in his shed. I don't know if Chris filmed. Did you film the shed or anything? Or no?
A little bit. Yeah, they can see all of this.
So, yeah, that's what we're going to do tomorrow. Well, we might do some here, too. But
yeah. So tomorrow, come on back. It'll be fun. We'll do more work. Tomorrow's going to be a beautiful day because it's supposed to be like 20 degrees. It's going to be awesome.
20 degrees. It's going to be.
This morning, it was 20 below.
Yeah, 40 degrees. Like, oh, that's way better.
Yeah. So that's it for today, folks. You know what to do. Poke the buttons. Hit them all. Hit the like, subscribe, share, all those things. Between now and tomorrow, get outside, get cutting.
Good night, Irene.